Hello guys, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today we are going to talk about fuel pump. In this topic, I will cover basically what is a fuel pump, how a fuel pump works. After that, I will explain the construction of plunger, and after that I will tell you how the fuel pump works, means how the fuel is injected inside a cylinder space. Okay, so let's see. What is a fuel pump? So basically, a fuel pump is a device which helps to inject the fuel at a high pressure into the cylinder. Now, why fuel pump is needed? Fuel pump is needed so that we can inject the fuel at a high pressure. Why we want to inject the fuel at a high pressure? So that it can atomize with air for ensuring complete combustion. Basically, in class MU class 4, a question is asked, what is atomization? So atomization is the process in which fuel is changed into droplet form by a high pressure injection and mixed with air for ensuring complete combustion. Okay, so basically in atomization, what we are doing, we are changing the fuel into droplet form. What we are achieving by changing the fuel into droplet form, we are basically increasing the surface area of the fuel. As the surface area of the fuel is increased, so that it get readily mixed with the air in a very short amount of time, and as it get mixed with the air, it can be ignited very easily and power can be derived from it for driving the crankshaft. Okay, so now let's see what are the part of fuel pump. Basically, as you can see, this is the delivery, high pressure delivery line. This is the delivery valve which open at a preset value. Okay, this is plunger barrel arrangement. This is rack, this is pinion, this is roller guide, this is spring, this is the cam. Okay, so I will give you a basic synopsis how a fuel pump works. Basically, the fuel is coming from this suction port and it filling up this space. Okay, as it filling this space, the oil is collected here. Now, as you can see, the cam is now on its base. When the cam will slowly come at its peak, the roller will push the plunger up against the spring. As the plunger is pushed up, the vertical grooves here will cover the suction port, and oil will start to get pressurized. After reaching a preset value, the delivery valve will open, and as the delivery valve will open, the oil, high pressurized oil, will go through high pressure pipe, will open the injector and will inject into the cylinder space. Okay, this rack and pinion arrangement basically control the amount of fuel injection through the helical grooves. Okay, by moving the rack up, in and out, we are controlling the amount of fuel and we are controlling the termination. Okay, now basically the spring here is provided so that it can bring back the plunger back to its original position after injection. Okay, now let's see the design of plunger. Now, as you can see, the plunger is having three groove: helical groove, vertical groove and circumferential groove. Now, all the three groove have its own value. The helical groove basically determine the termination of the injection by coinciding the top part of the plunger area to the spill port. Okay, the vertical groove basically covered the suction port so that it can start up the build up of the pressurization. Okay, so let's see what I have written here. Plunger generally move inside the barrel. Okay, the barrel and plunger arrangement, basically the plunger move up and down inside the barrel with a fine clearance provided. Okay, helical groove, vertical groove and circumferential groove help to control the amount of fuel to be injected inside the cylinder unit. Very clear. In Bosch type fuel pump, the start of injection is fixed. We are varying the end of injection to control the amount of fuel injection. Okay, this is very important point here, as I will explain you later on. This is how the Bosch type fuel pump work. Now as you can see, this is a suction port, this is a delivery valve. So the fuel is coming from here and will fill up the space. Okay, and the plunger is now sitting at the base of its cam here like this. Okay, the plunger is sitting on the base of its cam. Now as the plunger will start to move up, the vertical groove here, the vertical groove here will cover the suction port, and the oil present on top of it will now start to get pressurized. Okay, now as I have told you here, as you can see, I have told you in Bosch type fuel pump the start of injection is fixed. We are varying the end of injection. So what do I mean is basically is this, that the end of means the amount of fuel which will fill this area is fixed. We cannot vary the amount of fuel collected, but we can vary that when will the top part of the top area of the plunger where the fuel is accumulated will coincide with the spill port. As soon as the spill port coincided with the top part of the area of plunger, the injection terminate. Okay, so basically from this diagram, as you can understand, right now the suction port is closed, spill port is closed, and oil is getting pressurized. Now here the cam is reached at its peak position and delivery valve already here, the delivery is carrying, means as you can see, the as the oil is getting pressurized, the delivery valve is opening and oil is getting to the high pressure pipe. Now in this diagram the injection is terminated. How? Basically the cam, the plunger is moved to its peak position, and as well as the helix, the top part of the helix, the top part of the area of the plunger, the top part area of the plunger is sorted with the spill port, and the injection is terminated. Now this helical groove basically control that means the this area of the helical groove control when the injection will terminate. Means what do I mean, that basically the relative position of helix, means if the helix area is more, means whenever the piston, when the plunger is moving up at that time, if the, like as you can see in this diagram, this is a diagram when we want to terminate the injection or we want to stop the engine, at that time the rack is moved out. As the rack is moved out, the helical area is this much, and as soon as the plunger move up, the helical area will sort the top part of the plunger to the spill port, and therefore the delivery valve will not open and no suction will, no delivery will take place, and hence the no fuel will go, and therefore engine will derive from the fuel and engine will stop. Now as I am telling you, suppose the engine is running in no load condition, as the load is increases, the rack will move inside. As the rack is move inside, it means that the helical area is increased. As the helical area is increased, the end of injection is delayed. As the end of injection is delayed, more amount of fuel is admitted inside the cylinder space. As the helical area is decreased, the end of injection is now means made earlier, so the it is get the injection is terminated very early, and therefore the amount of fuel injection is reduced. So by this way, by moving the rack pinion arrangement in and up, in and means inside and outside, we are controlling the amount of fuel injection. Okay, so this is basically how the Bosch type fuel pump work. Please do like and subscribe my video, please, and the image credit goes to Marine Diesel SIP. Thank you, friend.